Welcome to this iTunes online video interview. Yep, we're really happy to have you. I'm gonna go straight into it. Do you see yourself as a role model for younger girls?
Yeah, I see myself
If you had to give any young girls advice, you know, if they wanted to enter into, let's say, 2012, and before they decide, what advice would you give them? Something that you had to learn throughout the process of the project, or did you know you were ready before you entered and all that stuff?
So if
your fellow contestants had to describe your personality, what do you think they would say about you? So, before you joined the project, did you have any expectations for, what Miss Barbie should be like? And since you've been in it, has the project, like, lived up to any expectations you had?
Well, I knew that this year was a new franchise. Mm-hmm. So I spent probably 3 days leading up to my application, just reading the website, everything on it, like, over and over, the purpose, the talent, everything. Then I went and Googled all the girls, like Leah and Matthew Brickett, who had won before, and, you know, to see what they had done, and how far they had gotten in the competition, not in this world, this world only, but in this world, and see if, well, could you be that next girl fashion? Then I told myself, yeah, I could be, if I really put my mind to it. And thus far, the competition has really prepared us, mentally and physically, to do the thing, and I would say it has lived up to my expectations. I continue to live up to my expectations.
So, tell me, what's your average photo scale? What do you get to order?
My average day. Honestly, I wake up early. Sometimes even before at like 6 o'clock. I head over to sometimes our men's government agencies, our men's government charity, get permission and whatnot. And then try to fit it in somewhere in there. And also during training sessions. Like tonight, we have training at 7, but I also have an interview at home at 5:30. So I have to make my way back home after this to try to get there in time. And then get down to where we have the rehearsal in time. And then probably get home at 11.
This is hot day.
It's usually a hot day. Sunday is what you know, rest day. It's all day, every day.
So, I mean, working every day and, you know, doing all this stuff, I mean, do you ever get, or do you ever feel like it's just too much or anything else?
Yeah, honestly, it feels like too much sometimes. Mm-hmm. It's totally getting too much. There's a lot more to this. Sacrificing it all for a lazy day. Just get up and try to go. It's not every day you're motivated to get up, especially when you're going to sleep at like 2 o'clock. You have to wake up at 4:30. You're so tired. But you have to go and look pretty. Try to wake up to look pretty and not have big bags on your eyes or whatever.
So like, And when you feel like that, is there like, do you have a team that you can lean off for like support or stuff like that, or your parents right here?
Well, I have my sister.
Mm-hmm.
She would be like, you gotta get up.
From the previous interview or whatever, I noticed that you said you had an appreciation for art.
Yeah.
So I wanted to ask you, what's your definition of an artist?
Of an artist?
Mm-hmm.
An artist is always someone who creates it. Mm-hmm. And sometimes you can be inspired from within. They don't need to see something and be like, oh, I want to do something like that. Mm-hmm. Or you'll be like, different to do this, but you just sit on the spot and think. It'd be really nice to combine these things and then interpret that and put it on whatever medium you use, whether you're a performing artist, a visual artist, like myself, in visual art, you have a painter, graphic, whatever it is that turns you through your art, because you guys want to do art.
I mean, it sounds like you're speaking from experience, so do you think? Because I find that a lot of people don't really understand how an artist's mind works. Do you think that people misunderstand you a lot of the time?
Pardon?
Do you think that people misunderstand you a lot of the time?
A lot of the time, as you write correctly, people really don't understand how an artist's mind is how an artist's mind works. A lot of the time, I sit and it
talking to like all the other girls and stuff, they keep telling me that they had a lot of training and like most things they have like meeting groups and stuff, but I know you're all only coming to the pageant as the finished article. So like, what do you think is the one thing you had to work on most in the pageant?
It was definitely being more outspoken and speaking up and coming out with my shot. Generally I'm very reserved, very quiet. Not that I don't go after what I want. It's just how I go about it. I may not be high or whatever. So I guess that is what I'm having not trouble changing, but I'm working hardest on changing that. And also being able to confront people and be confident and be like, hi, I'm excited here. I like this stuff. Instead of, would you be willing to do this? You know, be more assertive.
Yeah.
It's what I'm really working on.
Well, I come across as really confident. From the time I met you, I thought you were a really confident person.
Oh,
yeah, yeah.
So that means it's working.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. I mean, back to the Miss Flavorous pageant. Tell me about the big night. Like, what do you envision for it? Do you envision that would be perfect? Like, everything would go like, smoothly? Do you know, like, slip up to anything? Tell me what you're doing about.
Nerves. I am hoping nothing bad happens, like a fall or you get stuck at first, and that's like, and you know, make yourself look kind of silly. And I hope that everything works smoothly. I hope that I'm the girl who's going to perform my talent. And obviously, all of us want to win.
Yeah,
so I hope to be the one to become on that night.
So if you win, Who you thank the most, or who the person's gonna come to mind when they announce that you're the winner, or if they announce
that you're the winner? That is so hard, because I don't think I can thank one person, because I have to thank my family for the internal support, but then I have to thank the organization for the opportunity, I can't really put one in front of the other.
Fair enough. Okay. So, is there a separation between the real life station and the Miss Barbados station?
Just a little bit more standard English. My everyday life. I actually am more relaxed.
Mm-hmm.
Very sporting, as you can see.
Mm-hmm.
And pageant station, just a little bit more professional?
Yeah, definitely.
No, try to put my best foot forward and let everybody see the right thing. Because sometimes people can interpret other things the wrong way. So you really don't want that, especially when you know you're in the spotlight and you're trying to be a role model for other girls out there. You really want to be the best you can. But honestly, there isn't the best at all.
Yeah, no. Alright, last question. What's the most memorable moment so far along the McFarlane experience?
The most memorable moment. Again, this is hard because there's so many. But one day in particular, I think it was the day when we told the ladies all in court. Knowing that one of us will be driving home that mini.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and also later on that evening, we had a surprise camera run where we had our photos aren't out yet. But I'm really happy to be with me in those. That I would say was the best day. Mainly because it started early and ended late. But all in between was just fun and going. And not the usual hard working day.
Yeah, I get it. Well, thanks for coming out, you know. That was it. Start the seat.